240 EV form. How much did you make? How much will you give us? Here's what we're taking. Send it in. And they're done with it. They don't know itemized deductions or the earned income tax credit. All they know is what they make and what they pay, which in many cases, income tax-wise, isn't much. But they hear the word loophole and they think tax cheat. And so now, every legitimate, by law, itemized deduction is considered a loophole for the express purpose of eliminating it. Well, this is our private property we're talking about. Our money is as much our private property as anything else that we have earned and that we own. And Boehner has said, all right, I'll give you $800 million. They live in this world, they think, because of the election, that the American people want new taxes. They want new revenue. I'll tell you here, this is what boils it down to the essence. It's clear that they have no interest in teaching conservatism. It's clear they have no interest in defending it or standing up for it or explaining it even. And I think one of the reasons is that many of them really aren't conservatives. It used to be that the Republican Party and conservative meant the same thing. I don't think they do anymore, and that's been that way for a while. But they don't explain it. They don't take the opportunity to contrast it because they don't know it. And the rich now defines $200,000 a year. Anyway, in negotiations on this looming fiscal cliff, Obama has been insistent on the matter of raising taxes in the top 2%. Bloomberg interview yesterday said, just a matter of math, there's been a lot of talk that somehow we can raise $800 billion or a trillion worth of revenue by closing loopholes and deductions. It's not a realistic option. Yet it was just over a year ago, in the same negotiations with Republicans going on now on the debt reduction deal that never came to fruition, the White House proposed doing just that, $800 billion, raising revenue, closing loopholes and deductions. Yesterday, Obama says, can't do it. There's not that kind of money there. A year ago, he was all for it. Well, how do you negotiate with something like this? You don't. And then why do you bang somebody like this to come sit at the table with you? They can give you a proposal. In order to move forward, we've just given away something that used to be part of our brand. That's right, Russian. The brand is what's killing us. Republicans love the rich, and Boehner knows it. And that could be at the root of this, too. It could be. That these guys believe, the elected Republicans believe, that the average American thinks the only people the Republicans care about are the rich. And so let's get rid of that. Let's just raise taxes on them. Hell with it. I'm sick and tired of being called a friend of the rich. When in fact, it's Obama's got all the crony capitalist deals with all the rich guys. Could be that. Whatever, it's defensive. And whatever, it's reactionary. It certainly isn't proactive. Would you agree with that, certainly? From the article, taxes on the wealthy are going up. House Speaker John Boehner conceded today in challenging Obama to sit down with him to hammer out a deal for avoiding the fiscal cliff, you see. And the drive-bys, now we've got the framework for a deal. Finally, we're gonna blame the rich. We should have been doing that all along, and now Boehner's finally agreed, so okay, now we can move forward, blaming the rich. The last group of people with any money in the private sector have now officially been targeted. Vinny, the old reliable. Vinny's like old paper. And things blow up. Vinny from Queens somehow gets still here, and we welcome him back. Vinny, welcome back to EID Network, sir. How are you?
Hey, Rush. It's great to talk to you again.
You sound thrilled, Vinny.
Well, it's a little tough these days, and I've been listening to you because you're about the only anchor I have.
Let me see if I can properly characterize how you feel for you. I'm going to take a wild guess instead. And if I'm wrong, feel free to say so. The election happened. invested, I don't know how many years listening to this program, you've invested a lot of years watching Fox. You have